second, I noticed you talking amongst yourself there, you know, down by the baseline. What do you guys take it from this game?
It doesn't matter who play day in and day out. It's just we can play against anybody in this league, to be honest. We just got to be able to put two halves together to really solidify that as being championship run.
Is there anything you guys said to each other when you were down 18 to be able to, you know, start that rally?
No, there's not really. Just a look that it comes from everybody. It's just like, you got to play. So we go out there and we got to play together and play for each other.
What did you think of Toppin's game now that you've seen it up close instead of just on tape?
Well, I mean, he played last year, so you know, he's a good player.
Taking a step up this year, I would say. Would you agree with that?
Yeah.
What stands out about his game?
I don't know, I'm just guarding it. I'm not an analyst, so.
Can you only really just speak to what the kind of energy that TV did give you and come back there to create your ball and that sort of thing?
He gave us great energy. He kind of came into the huddle and was really fired up and was really telling us, he was telling everybody in the huddle that we're not going to lose this game by 20 points or anything like that. We're just going to go out fighting and we're just going to live with the end result. So he really came out and gave us a huge spark and he got the crowd really involved and he just did an overall good job.
This may be hard to answer right now, but does this feel like the type of game that, you know, right now it obviously hurts, but maybe tomorrow or the next day you'll say, listen, we'll play with the representative of the country or anything better, or do you not take those guys more of a victory?
It really doesn't matter.
Defensively, oh, go ahead.
Joe asked Michael about Toppin. How about some of their other guys and how they were utilized aside from him? What's your takeaway from playing against them that you can apply when you see these guys again?
They got a very good team. Obviously, OB is the catalyst for him. He's super athletic. And one of the things we try to do is just try to eliminate his athleticism plays, the rose to the rim from the naked side. And stuff like that. With the other guys, they really know their roles, so it's kind of difficult, but it's kind of not difficult. It's just they're a really good team, and they know the stuff they run, and they run the stuff very well.
Michael, looks like you're agreeing. I feel like you learned a lot about how they work for next time, if nothing else.
I mean, you always take that in consideration with every game, so just feel like, just for the feel of the game, how they apply it, their pressure, where they apply it, is really the biggest thing. And also, it's just playing more simple. I mean, I feel like we got too uptight about things, and I kind of felt like we were forcing that first, but then once we kind of settled down, got those nerves out, we really played the game. But I think we played the right way. Just to figure out how to, those minutes were just more relaxing. I think we just figure it out. That's also going to come from practice.
Marcus, what did you learn about your team in the last three games, two games in a road trip and this game tonight?
We just got a lot of guys that got a lot of fight, especially with this game. I know the previous two games have kind of been a little bit sluggish, and on the defensive end, we've kind of been lagging a little bit on that end as well. But from what I've seen in a little bit of the second half, we have a team that really fought hard. We really tried to come back and make it a really close game with those guys. So kind of the things that Mike said, we're just going to go back to the drawing board and get back in practice and keep practicing hard and keep pounding the stuff we know.
To either of you, defensively, with what they're able to do with screens and setting up shots, what were your principles tonight and how do you feel you executed those?
The principles were just to stay extra longer for the sit-ins, especially on the naked side road dudes where OB was coming out, just so he doesn't get a clear lane for a dunk and uses athleticism and really energizes guys. And for the most part, we did a pretty good job of
How much of that beginning of the second half was maybe a byproduct at the end of the first half with the empty possession and then their run and then the buzzer beater and then their run to start the second?
Personally, I don't feel like that kind of had anything to do with it. Honestly, I couldn't even really tell you why we started off so slow. It just happened. You know, sometimes in the games it kind of happens and stuff like that. We needed guys like Tavian to step up and really get the team energized and get the team going. So he did a really good job of that.
Marcus, you think it's possible sometimes to prove more in a loss than you do in a win?
I can kind of see it that way. As far as this loss goes, I feel like it's a super good learning experience, especially for us, because in the last two games we haven't come out with that kind of fire and intensity, especially on the defensive end, causing turnovers and things like that. So I can definitely see the side of that.